The needs of the young versus older folks, empty wallets. Lakota Schools are once again at a crossroads, and News 5's John London joins us live to put faces on both sides of the levy debate. John?
Yeah, Jack, those who run schools in this district, like the one behind me, Lakota West, say they've taken steps to right size. Now they are asking voters if the size of a levy they want to put on in November feels right to them. 4.75 mils, it would add $140 to every $100,000 worth of property value in this district, a sore point to some small business owners and to those on fixed incomes.
Put your hand up.
The fee just to step onto the Firebird Field is straining some family budgets this summer. For players like Lakota West receiver Jalen Kennedy, seems like a busted hand will heal faster than the financial injury.
Fees helps, pays $550 to play football right now, so we have fundraisers, you know, to help play. So,
with three grandkids in the district, Alan Slattery is sympathetic, but some homeowners around here would see property taxes go up by $700 and more if a Lakota levy succeeds.
Lots of people are on fixed income or getting close to that, so there's all these pressures.
The pressure is on Lakota's 22 schools again.
Over the past 3 years, we've had significant reductions in our spending.
These students have fewer programs and teachers, less transportation, and $22 million fewer operating dollars, which worries parents like Brian Skoog and Joel Rivers, who were tossing all this around after tennis team practice today.
You know, we reduce this course or that course, and there's just not as many options for the students.
We really need the funds. I mean, Lakota West has always been known for being athletic and academic.
The small businessman who runs Jamie's Landscaping carries that pride, has two kids in the district, but with a monthly tax bill of $2,000 just for his frontage, he's tapped out.
We don't have any more money. You know, they've got all they can get, and they've got to make do with what they have. You know, we need better leadership at the school, and, you know, something's got to change, but we don't have any more money to give Lakota.
All right, so that's the backdrop for tonight's vote by the board to put a 4.75 mil levy on the ballot in November. It is smaller than the two most recently rejected by voters. The last one to pass here was 6 years ago. The new school year opens here in Lakota in just over a couple of weeks. Reporting live in Westchester, John London, News.